Good morning students, this is Asha, your social science teacher. Yesterday we started chapter 2 in geography, Inside Our Earth, and we discussed about interior of earth, what all are there. Then we discussed about crust and its properties. Then we discussed about mantle, and thereafter we discussed about core. We discussed the three layers of earth: crust, mantle and core yesterday in detail, and today we'll be discussing about rocks and minerals, what exactly they are. So children, the surface of earth is made up of rocks, which are composed of mineral substances found in solid state. So on surface we do see a lot of rocks, and what they are made up of mineral substances and in solid state. A rock in general, we can say is a piece of earth mostly made up of mixture of minerals. What exactly minerals are? Minerals are naturally occurring chemical compounds. So I hope you must have studied in grade 6 that minerals are naturally occurring compounds, and rock is mixture of these minerals. The minerals like feldspar and quartz are common constituent of rocks, because feldspar and quartz is a mineral which is found on earth's surface. It is very abundant. So most of the rocks which we will find will have this. Most of the rocks will have these constituents. There are thousands of minerals, but most of the rocks are made up of few specific minerals. Minerals of silicates are most abundant. So silicate minerals are very easily found everywhere. So on rocks can be of different color, size and texture, and there are three major types of rocks: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rock. So we'll be discussing each rocks one by one. So let's start with igneous rocks. So what exactly igneous rocks are? The igneous rocks are also known as primary rocks. So yes, these rocks are also known as primary because they are believed to be the first rocks formed on the earth's surface. So geologists say that igneous rocks were the first rock to form on the earth. That's why they are called as primary rocks. All other rocks are ultimately derived from igneous rocks only. They cover large percentage of earth crust. Magma. Before the formation of crust, magma was in solid state. So as many geologists say that earth was initially in molten state, and gradually and slowly it cooled and the upper layers solidified and formed crust, and this crust was formed of molten magma. So igneous rocks. So the first rock to be formed on earth's surface was igneous rock. Its upper layer cooled and became surface of earth, which gave rise to these rocks, that is igneous rocks. These rocks continue to be formed even today. Even today igneous rocks are formed. Molten material in the interior of earth is known as magma. When it comes out of the cracks in 100 kilometer deep layer through volcano, it is called as lava, which on cooling forms igneous rocks, right, on the surface of the earth. So molten magma, when through vent it comes out on the earth's surface and cools down, it's for that lava, when it cools down it forms rock. What are these rocks? These are igneous rocks. When igneous rocks are formed on the surface of earth, they are called extrusive igneous rocks, and when they are formed inside the earth, they are called intrusive igneous rocks. So we can say there are two types of igneous rock: intrusive and extrusive. Let's discuss them in detail. So what exactly intrusive and extrusive rocks are? Sometimes the molten magma cools down inside the earth crust. So at times what happened, magma is not able to come outside and it cools down inside the earth crust only. And solid rocks formed are called intrusive igneous rocks. Whereas when molten lava comes on the earth's surface, it rapidly cools down and becomes solid. So when the rocks which form in this way on the crust are called extrusive igneous rocks. These rocks are formed outside the crust or above the earth's surface. They are extrusive, and the one which are formed inside the earth are intrusive. The intrusive rocks cool down slowly, so they form large grains. On the other hand, extrusive rocks cool down rapidly. They are on the surface of the earth, they cool down very rapidly, so they have very small grains. Whereas on the other hand, intrusive rocks take great amount of time to settle, so their large grains are formed. The example of extrusive rocks is basalt, and intrusive rocks granite. So children, there is an important thing. Granite, gabbro are examples of intrusive rocks. These rocks are very strong, hard and non-porous and valuable. So intrusive rocks are really very hard and non-porous. And one thing which we need to remember, igneous rocks never contain fossils and are rarely layered. So igneous rocks are never layered and they do not contain fossils also. They are crystalline in structure. So children, let's move on to the next layer, which is sedimentary rocks. So how these sedimentary rocks are formed? The original rocks were broken due to action of erosion by agents of gradation like flowing river. So original rocks, I mean here primary rocks or the igneous rocks. They are broken due to the action of erosion by agents of gradation like flowing river, wind, sea waves. And these small broken rock pieces deposited in river beds along valleys. These deposits or segments gradually accumulate in layers. So these fragments or these sediments, they move by wind, air, water, and they get gradually accumulated in layers. These layers in due course of time are compressed and cemented, form stratified rocks called sedimentary rocks. And then these types of after compression and hardening form sedimentary rocks. Some examples of sedimentary rocks are sandstone, shale, gravel, and sedimentary rocks contain fossils of plants and animal also. So that's why we get a lot of fossil fuel in sedimentary rocks only. Now let's move on to the next, that is metamorphic rock. Metamorphic rocks, what exactly they are? When rocks are located very deep in the earth, then due to excessive external pressure and internal heat of the earth, or partial complete change occur in their structure and chemical properties. When a particular rock is subjected to extreme heat and pressure, what happens? They change their chemical properties and structure, and a new rock is formed. So this rock thus formed are different in appearance and characteristic. So the new rock which will be formed will be totally different in characteristic as well as look. You can say look. So these are called metamorphic rock. So igneous and sedimentary rocks can change into metamorphic rock under great heat and pressure. This process of metamorphism takes place at a great depth of 12 km to 16 km below the earth's surface. So metamorphosis process do not take on this place on the surface of earth. It takes below the surface of earth, where temperature and pressure both are very high. Both igneous and sedimentary rocks undergo metamorphosis, and after being formed at such a depth, these rocks reach upper surface of the earth due to internal forces and became available to us. Due to some internal forces, they come to us. Limestone gets converted to marble, which differs from limestone in properties and also beautiful and precious. So limestone is a sedimentary rock and it goes under metamorphosis and forms a marble, which is very beautiful. So metamorphosed rocks are mostly, most of the time you will see metamorphic rocks are beautiful, bright and precious. Some important metamorphic rocks are quartzite, slate, diamond, sapphire. All these are metamorphic rocks. So children, let's wrap up. And tomorrow's lecture will discuss about rock cycle and uses of rocks to humankind. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.